Hello students, welcome back to my YouTube channel. So don't forget to subscribe my TikTok page. Thank you so much. With that, our quarter four week five objectives. So at the end of the lesson, you should be able to 1. Define and illustrate mean, median, and mode. Number 2. Solve the mean, median, and mode of ungrouped data. Number 3. Cite real-life applications of the measures of central tendency. Ito yung kailangan nyo matutunan or ma-master this week. So with that, let's define. Pag sinabi natin central tendency or measure of central tendency, this is also known as measures of location. Okay, when we say measure of central tendency, this is simply a numerical descriptive measure which locates the center of the distribution. It is a single central value that summarizes a set of numerical data kung saan nga ba siya makikita. So, pag sinabi natin central tendency, there are 3. We have the mean, median, and mode. So, let's define. But before that, no, saan nga ba ginagamit yung central tendency na to? So, kapag meron po tayong data set, okay, so when we say data set, this is simply a group or a collection of data. Ano-ano nga ba yung collection of data natin? Okay, pwede siyang test scores or pwede siyang height and weight of an object or it might be scientific measurement in the investigation or it can be age of members in the family. So ilan lamang ito sa halimbawa ng data set natin. So with that, we are going to define what is the difference between the mean, median, and mode. Okay, so when we say mean, this is simply commonly known as the average or the arithmetic mean. Okay, paano nga ba kukunin yung arithmetic mean na to? Or the average, simply the sum of every values divided by the number of the values in the data set. So meron tayong formula to for the ungrouped data. So meaning to say, get the sum of the given data and divided by the number of the data. Ilan ba yung number mo doon? Okay, for n, yung x, so may bar natin, that is mean. Yun yung ibig sabihin. Yung sigma naman, tapos may x, meaning to say summation nyo. Summation, meaning to say, sum of the measurements or values. And yung n natin dyan, that is small letter n, total number of measurement or values. So with that, dito naman sa ating median, when we say median, no, this is the middle value or middle point. So of the data set, whose values are arranged in increasing, pag sabi increasing, lowest to highest, or decreasing naman highest to lowest. So kailangan ma-arrange muna natin siya bago natin mahanap yung median. Speaking of middle number, no, so meron tayong dalawang cases para ma-determine natin yung middle number. Okay, so we have the case 1, this is known as the odd number of observation. When we say odd, ito po yung not divisible by 2. We have the 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, so on and so forth. So kapag nakita natin odd yung bilang ng ating number of observation doon or data, i-apply natin yung case 1. Kapag yung given naman natin na number of observation is even, when we say even number, no, that is 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, so on and so forth, divisible by 2. So, i-apply naman natin yung case 2 na to. Okay, so with that, punta na naman tayo dito sa mode. When I say mode, this is simply refers to the most frequent occurring value in the set of data. Ito po yung maraming naulit na number doon sa data set mo. Okay, so with that, we have the different symbol na pag sinabing mean, ito po yung symbol niya. So, X, tapos meron siyang guhit sa taas. Ito naman sa median, o X pa rin, tapos may alon siya doon sa taas. And sa mode naman, okay, X pa rin, pero may ganito yung kanyang yung symbol sa taas. So with that, we have to be mindful of these different symbols para ma-identify natin kung siya ba ay mean, median, or mode. Okay, so with that, we are going to solve the example number 1. So the number of books borrowed in the library from Monday to Friday last week were 44, 60, 37, 35, and 44 respectively. So with that, hahanapin natin yan yung mean, median, and mode. Okay, remember, the formula to find the mean is get the sum of the given data and divided by the number of the data. So meaning to say, apply natin yung formula na yung summation over n. So meaning to say, add lang natin yung 44 plus 60 plus 37 plus 35 plus 44 divide by 5 kasi 5 yung number ng data natin. Yun yung n natin doon. Okay, that is 220 yung summation niya or that is a sum. divide natin by 5, that is the mean or the average ngayon ay 44. Pero lang ang simple kung paano siya makuha ang average. So, next naman natin kukunin ay yung median. Diba? Median is the middle number. So, paano ba natin ma-identify kung ito ba ay case 1 or case 2? Bilangin natin yung number ng data or we call that number of observation. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, since 5 yan, that is add. Diba? 1, 3, 5, 7, so on so forth. Not divisible by 2. Kaya nga siya add. So, i-apply natin dyan yung case 1 kasi add yung number of observation natin. So, therefore, the solution would be ayan, so yan yung formula natin, N plus 1 over 2 TH. Okay, ibig sabihin ng TH dyan, ito pa yung term. Okay, ibig sabihin, pang ilang term ba yung magiging number natin na nasa median or nasa middle. So with that, i-apply na natin yung formula. So since there are 5 number of observations, yun yung N natin. Kaya substitute natin, that is 5 plus 1, that is 6. Kaya nga, 6 TH or 6 term divide by 2, that is 3. Kaya nga, ibig sabihin niyan yung magiging median natin or middle number ay nasa pangatlong term siya. Okay, kapag nahanap mo na yung number of term, isulat mo ngayon yung iyong number of books borrowed. Kailangan naka-arrange siya, di ba? In ascending. Okay, ibig sabihin lowest to highest. So, kung gusto mo highest to lowest, pwede rin siya. Okay, so with that, 35, 37, 44, 44, 60. Ngayon, lagyan mo ng term. So, ito yung first term, second, third, fourth, fifth. Ngayon, di ba ang sagot natin sa median? Nasa pangatlong term. Kaya ito siya ngayon. So, take note, ito yung 44 natin ay median, no? So, take note, this is one middlemost data. Kaya siya yung pinakagitna. Since isa lang siya, understood siya na yun. Kasi nga, add. And that is our answer for the median. And for the mode naman, when we say mode, no, this is most frequent appear in your data. So, kung titignan natin yan, i-arrange lang natin. Or pwede rin hindi, no? Okay, as long as you can determine the most frequent in your data or the number appear. So, meaning to say, 35, 37, 44, 44, 60, ano nga yun yung most frequent natin? So, that is 44. Ibig sabihin yan, naulit yung 44 na dalawang beses. Kaya that is most frequent. Kaya that is our answer. So, take note. So, since isa lang yung most frequent natin dyan, we call that unimodal. When we say unimodal, isa lang yung naulit na number doon sa ating data set. So, that is unimodal. Okay, so with that, let's go on number 2. So, the age of 8 students in Mr. Cruz's class are 18, 16, 19, 15, 17, 18, 16, and 21. Same with this, so find the mean, median, and mode. So, kailangan ma-recall natin yung formula to find the mean, simply i-add lang natin lahat and divide by the number of the data, the number. And then, we have this summation over n. So, meaning to say, add natin 18 plus 16 plus 19 plus 15 plus 17 plus 18 plus 16 plus 21 divide by 8. Kasi 8 po yung number natin doon sa data. Kasi 8 yung age ng students. And then, that is 140 divide by 8. So, ngayon, kapag dinivide natin yan, the average or the mean is 17.5. Yan yung average natin. Okay, next, for the mode naman, when we say mode, diba? Median, when we say median, this is refers to the middle number in your data. Okay, balikan natin yung ano natin, no, rules. Okay, paano ko malalaman kung case 1, case 2? Kapag ang given natin ay, ang number of observations ay divisible by 2, that is even. Okay, tignan natin kung even, ilan ba yung number natin dyan na age? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So, since 8 yan, okay, that is for case 2. Kasi nga, even number yung observation natin. So, with that, i-apply na natin yung formula or the for the case 2. So, meaning to say, 1 half of the, okay, itong buong to, no? So, n over 2 term plus n over 2 plus 1 term. Okay, then the simplify of this, kukunin natin yung kalahati niya or di-divide natin by 2. Yun yung magiging median natin or yun yung magiging middle number natin. Okay, so with that, we are going to substitute now. Since meron tayong 8, no? 8 observation, kaya 8 yung i-replace mo sa n. And that will become 8 divided by 2, that is 4. Okay, kaya ilagay muna natin 4. And 8 divided by 2, 4 yun. 4 plus 1, kaya 5th term siya. Copy mo lang yung TH. And then, ibig sabihin nito, yung magiging median natin ngayon dyan, na kukunin natin yung one half niya, ay nasa pang-apat at pang-limang term. Okay, para ma-identify natin kung ano nga ba yung nasa fourth or fifth term. Ilista natin, di ba? In ascending or descending. Kailangan naka-ano siya ng order. 15, 16, 16, 17, 18, 18, 19, 21. So ngayon, ilagyan natin ang number of term para ma-identify natin. Kukunin natin yung 4th at 5th term. Saan ba yung number na yan? Yung 17 at 18. Ito ngayon ang magiging middle number natin. Ibig sabihin yan, nandyan sa pagitan ng dalawang numbers. Kasi even sila. So ibig sabihin yan, since there are two middlemost, yan yung two middlemost data natin, i-divide natin. Kaya nga, i-add muna natin 17 plus 18, that is 35, divide by 2, or one half of that, that is equal to 17.5. Ibig sabihin, 17.5 ay nasa gitna ng 17 tsaka 18. Yun po yung median natin. Okay, next, for the mode naman natin, when we say mode, diba, that is the most frequent appear. So, di ba, ang gagawin mo lang dyan, i-arrange lang natin, either in ascending or descending. Okay, so, and then, that is the symbol. So, we have the 15, 16, 17, si 15, 16, 16, 17, 18, 18, 19, 21. So, ngayon, titignan mo ngayon dyan, ano nga ba yung most frequent natin, di ba? So, ibig sabihin niya, meron tayong 16, kasi dalawang beses siya na ulit yung 16. Tapos, meron pang 80. Okay, since pare sila ng number na naulit na dalawa, okay, sila yung magiging most frequent natin, or that is the mode. Kaya, our answer for the mode is, ayan, so 16 and 18. Di ba, kung mapapansin yung dalawa, anong tawag dun kapag dalawa? Bimodal. Kung say bimodal, kapag ang nakuha nating number of most frequent appear or in your data is 2. Kapag tatlo naman pataas na yan, okay, that is multimodal na. Kapag wala, no modal siya. Okay, kapag one, isa lang, that is unimodal. So with that, we are going to summarize, no, to find the mean, median, and mode of the following data set. Okay, so ito number one, test scores, okay, given yung 1, 8, 3, 2, and 6. To find the mean, di ba, add lang natin, divide by 5, kasi 5 yung data natin. And that is 4. Dito naman sa median natin, arrange mo yan, either in ascending or descending. Kaya ang nasa middle niya, that is 3. Okay, di ba? Ito yung ating odd number. Di ba, in-apply natin yung case 1. Sa mode naman, okay, di ba, most frequent. Meron bang naulit dyan? Since wala, ang sagot natin is no mode. Okay, next, number 2. The daily February temperatures in degrees Celsius for days in Quezon City are 25, 21, 22, 24, 22, and 21. Okay, same with that, hanapin natin yung mean, di ba? Add lang natin yung 6 na measures ng temperature, divide natin by 6, kasi 6 yung data natin. That is 22.5. And the median naman natin, since there are 6, even yun, kaya apply mo yung case to doon. Kaya our median is 22. And then the mode naman is 21 and 22 kasi pare silang naulit na dalawang beses, yung 21 at 22. Kaya sila yung mode natin. Meaning to say, this is bimodal. And with that, let's apply, no, sa real-life problems. Paano nga ba ginagamit yung tatlong central tendency? So, for example, John played golf at an amusement park. His scores on the first five holes were 1, 5, 4, 6, and 4. So the question is, what was his average scores for these holes? Diba? The word average refers to the mean. Kaya nga, i-add mo lang lahat yung score niya and then divide natin by 5. Yun yung formula natin, yung get the sum of this and divide by n. Yun yung number of the data. And that is 1 plus 5 plus 4 plus 6 plus 4, that is equal to 20 divided by 5. Kasi 5 yung ano natin dyan, number ng kanyang score. And that is equal to 4. Yan ngayon yung mean or the average ni John doon sa kanyang paglalaro ng golf sa amusement park. Next, number 2. The number of service upgrades sold by each of 7 employees is as follows. We have the 6, 21, 10, 8, 11, 12, 15. Ang tanong dyan, what is the middlemost number of service upgrades sold by the 7 employees? Diba? Kung titignan natin dyan, paano kung malalaman kung ito ba ay mean, median, or mode? The word middlemost, di ba? Middle, that is the median. Okay, so with that, i-apply natin dyan either either kung ito ba siya ay case 1 or case 2. Since 7, di ba, that is add. Kaya nga, just simply, arrange mo lang siya. Okay, in ascending or descending. Since na-arrange mo na ano nga ba yung nasa middlemost natin or nasa gitna. Kaya that is, yan, pang fourth term siya. Ano nga ba yung pang fourth term? That is 11. Di ba? And that is our median or the middle number, the data set. And next, number 3, the height of 6 basketball players are 6 feet, 5, 6, 7, 5, and 6 feet. The question is, what is the most common height of the players? Pag sinabi natin most common, no? So, eto ngayon yung mode natin kasi most frequent. So, ano yung typical dyan na height na nakikita natin? So, that is, ayan, diba? Isusulat muna natin yan, arrange natin. In ascending or descending. Kaya makikita mo yan, ano yung mas maraming na ulit na height nila or most frequent? That is 6 feet. Kaya nga, that is the mode, 6 feet. And for the last problem, the average of set of 50 numbers is 38. If the 5 numbers, 45, 39, 48, 40, and 38 are discarded, when we say discarded, tinanggal po nila doon yung 5 numbers doon sa 50 na set. Ibig sabihin niya, nabawasan na lang 5. Magiging 45 na lang yung numbers natin. So ngayon, ang question dyan, what is the mean of the remaining set of numbers? Okay, so di ba, the word mean or the average, yun yung clue natin dyan. And our solution would be, di ba, ito yung mean natin, summation of the data divided by the total number of ano data natin. And since given na yung mean natin dyan, i-replace mo lang. Okay, yung summation kasi natin dyan is 1,900. Over 50 kasi 50 yung number ng set natin. And kapag na-chinect mo yan, di ba, 1,900 divided by 50, 38 yun. Okay, so with that, so dito ngayon tayo magsisimula para paano ko ba malalaman yung magiging mean natin doon sa remaining set of numbers. Ang gagawin lang natin, di ba, tinanggal yung 5 numbers na yan, isusubtract natin yun doon sa 1,900. Kasi, di ba, para malaman yung remaining. Okay, with that, ang total ng tinanggal natin dyan ay 210. So, subtract mo ngayon doon sa 1,900. And that is 1,690 lang yung natira natin. Okay, ibig sabihin yan, yung natira natin, ibig sabihin yung 45 numbers, di ba, binawas natin yung 5, ibig sabihin meron na lang tayo 45 na set yung numbers natin. So dito ngayon kukunin natin yung mean. I-divide lang natin siya by 45. Okay, so meaning to say, the remaining set of numbers is 1,690 divided by 45. And the new average or the remaining mean, the remaining or the mean of the remaining set of the numbers is 37.5. So yan na yung sagot natin sa average. Okay, so with that, I hope you learned something from this video. And so we'll see you next time. Goodbye. And don't forget to subscribe my TikTok page. Goodbye.